viewers all over the world, welcome to Prophetic Channel, where God is speaking today. This is the fifth edition of the Parak in 2021 and the 44th volume of the Parak Daily Devotional, where we blossom every day through the powerful messages of the prophet, our father, Major Prophet Shepherd Bushiri. And today, the 20th of May, the topic of the day is set your love on him. As the prophet went ahead of time, he went and lived in this day before we lived it, and extracted the message of the day, and extracted the topic of the day, and extracted the verse of the day. And today we are now in this day where we are reading what the prophet has written for us to be in line with in this day. And by the way, I'm joined by a powerful man of God, Brother Donald. We welcome you, man of God.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure to be here.
In the message of the day, the prophet goes on to say, our open verse unveils God's prophetic utterance through David's inspired words. He began by sharing his testimony of God from his perspective. Then the Spirit of God took over and brought this prophetic utterance from the lips of the Father. When you read the preceding verses, you will notice that David was the one speaking from his own inspired words and the personal testimony of God. So Prophet King David, the prophet, was giving a testimony of God. God spoke through him.
So he was now the mouthpiece of God at this particular time.
Amen. As a prophet is the mouthpiece of God. Suddenly, there was a change into the prophetic utterance. God began to speak, and he said, because he had set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. Isn't this inspiring?
This is amazing, man of God.
It's so powerful.
He said, because they have known my name, I will set him on high.
Oh, yes.
Just because you know his name.
Because you know. So, by knowing the name of God, you are set at a higher position.
There's a dimension where God puts you just because of knowing.
Amen.
Man of God, our Father taught us one thing. There's something about knowing that I always emphasize.
Amen.
That knowing is something different.
Amen.
Because if you know, you have faith. No one can remind you what you know.
Amen.
Man of God, believing and knowing, they are two different things.
Oh, yes.
But if you know that God will deliver me here. Mm-hmm. So here God is saying, he had known my name.
Amen.
You know his name. You have facts about him. You don't need anyone to tell you anything about him.
Oh, yes.
That's the truth. So if me, I know that God, because I know his name,
yes,
he will set me there.
Yes. I love it when our mother speaks it, our mother, Prophetess Mary Bushiri. Mm. She says it's the elengos, evidence of the glory. Oh, yes. So our Father continues to say, he is talking about God's protection. The question is, have you set your love upon him? If you set your love upon the Lord, the result is he will deliver you and set you on high. So when you set your love upon God, two things happen. You will be delivered by God, and then you will be lifted up. You will be set on a high position.
So there's a dimension where you have to set your love.
Yes.
On God.
Yes.
And after you set your love on God,
yes,
then there is a sure way that you are delivered.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And our Father goes on to say, that means you are forever set up for greatness and limitless possibilities in life. All you need is to set your love upon him. This is something you have to do, and then claim the result for yourself. So when you set your love on God, knowing that you have set your love on God, and then you must claim it, because you know, having knowledge that you have set your love on God, you must claim it. For the results are there.
So claim, you must claim it, because the results belong to you.
Yes.
It is said, the results are there, but you must claim them, because you have put your love on him.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen. And our Father, the prophet, the demonstrator of God's power, on the action point, he's a man of action. Mm. You know, he's.
I know him. I know him very well. I know him.
Oh yes.
I have evidence with him.
Oh yes.
I have a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I have testimonies.
Oh, yes.
Of his action.
Amen. So our Father on the action point, he says, if you set your love upon the Lord, he will not only deliver you, he will also honor you. If you already have your hands up in praise to him, you will dance for joy. Scripture says, with the long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Psalm 91 verse 16. Whenever we decide to set our love on God, there are great rewards, deliverance, elevation, honor, grace, prosperity, and so much more are ours. So the prophet is explaining that whenever we decide to set our love on God, there are great rewards. And the rewards are what the prophet has written here, that there's deliverance,
elevation.
There's elevation, there's honor, there's grace, there's prosperity, and so much more.
Which means there are more things ahead.
Yes. So the moment we set our love on God, we deserve it. They are released. So this is a package that is released when you set your love on God.
And our Father is telling us to claim it. Which means you must claim your deliverance.
Oh yes.
You must claim your elevation.
Oh yes.
You must claim your honor.
Oh yes.
You must claim the grace, prosperity, and Amen. More things that
Amen.
They are for you.
Amen. And our Father goes on to say, all this is found in God, is given to us because we chose to love him consciously and soberly. So when you set in your love on God, you don't set your love on God by having two minds. If you're setting your love on God, it must be God. If you're setting your love on the world, it must be the world. So the moment you, and both sides have got rewards. But the prophet is explaining now that if you set your love on God, and then God will, there are rewards that he has already explained, that the deliverance, prosperity, honor, grace, and so much more, some things that we don't deserve will be given to us because we have set our love on him.
And there is no in between here.
Amen.
It's either you are there or you are this side.
Oh yes, there's no in between.
Amen.
That's true, man of God. And the prayer of today, our Father says, as we raise our right hands, let us all follow up in the prayer that the prophet has declared over our lives today. Let's say, Dear Heavenly Father,
Dear Heavenly Father,
I thank you for keeping me in permanent safety.
I thank you for keeping me in permanent safety.
For the life of greatness.
For the life of greatness.
You have brought me into.
You have brought me into.
You are my strength.
You are my strength.
My glory.
My glory.
And my salvation.
And my salvation.
I love you with all my heart.
I love you with all my heart.
Thank you.
Thank you
for the infinite kindness,
for the infinite kindness,
grace and mercy,
grace and mercy
that I experienced today,
that I experienced today.
In Jesus name, amen.
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 Viewers all over the world, thank you for your time. We appreciate it.
And
shalom.
Shalom.